The POS 2 has received several important features that will help you work more efficiently. Skeleton layers navigation. Now you can quickly switch between characters without using the layer panel. To do that, enable the skeleton layers navigation option. Open the quick menu by pressing Ctrl. Move the cursor away from the menu until it changes and click on the character. That saves you from having to search for the desired character in the layer panel. Floating handles. Floating handles duplicate controllers for the selected bone. That's useful when the required bone is outside the viewport. For example, sometimes when I need to adjust the spacing of the fox's nose, I have to zoom in so close to the tip that the head bones are no longer visible on the screen. In such cases, I select the bone and transform it using floating handles. By the way, you can customize the size and position of the floating panel on the screen. You can enable it in the settings or via the quick menu. Relative keyframing for bones. This is my favorite new feature of all. It allows you to make pose adjustments across entire frame ranges, which greatly speeds up work when something needs tweaking. Simply enable relative keyframing in the timeline panel, select the keyframes where changes should occur, and make the necessary adjustments. Make sure there are enough keyframes at the beginning and the end of the motion. The best part is that this feature fully supports all types of transformations for the tool. You can even use follow bones to adjust the entire motion at once. Use it cautiously and try to make individual adjustments for each motion to avoid unwanted results. If poses change significantly within a single motion, you can split it into separate parts. I hope you enjoy these new features. Let me know in the comments if you do.